Wednesday, June 3rd, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled Violence in the Land, Part 2, and our scripture is Acts chapter 5. The captain went with his temple guards and arrested the apostles, but without violence, for they were afraid the people would stone them. Then they brought the apostles before the high council, where the high priest confronted them. "We gave you strict orders never again to teach in this man's name," he said. "Instead, you filled all Jerusalem with your teaching about him. You want to make us responsible for his death." But Peter and the apostles replied, "We must obey God rather than any human authority." Looking further ahead to Acts chapter 5, verse 40, "They called in the apostles and had them flogged. Then they ordered them never again to speak in the name of Jesus, and they let them go." The apostles left the high council rejoicing that God had counted them worthy to suffer disgrace for the name of Jesus. And every day, in the temple and from house to house, they continued to teach and preach this message: Jesus is the Messiah. As the disciples are busy going about doing what Jesus had given them to do, spread the good news of resurrection, salvation, and God's great love, the ruling elders in Jerusalem are plotting. They come off as wily coyote chasing after the roadrunner, constantly pursuing after Peter and the others, but never quite able to get a firm grip or hold them in prison for very long. Court appearances, flogging, warnings, and political wranglings all come to nothing. The very thing they tried to prevent, the disciples getting their message out about Jesus, is how this chapter ends, with the apostles teaching and preaching every day in the temple and from house to house. Well, beep, beep. There are some things that, despite man's best efforts and best intentions, are not going to be stopped or controlled in any way. Tsunamis are that kind of thing, along with climate shifts, hurricanes, and a movement orchestrated by the Spirit of God. Often in the scriptures, we see God moving at a time when God is picked. Moses had that discussion with God at the burning bush. God had chosen that moment and that man to set God's chosen free. Pharaoh found out how unwise it was to fight against the hand of Yahweh. It cost him the life of his own firstborn son, as well as his entire army drowned in the Red Sea. Earlier, another leader, Nimrod, decided he wanted to be God over this earth, so he constructed a tower to declare his strength against all who would dispute him. His tower came down in a crumbling mess because God decided otherwise. I see the same extraordinary kind of thing happening in our land. There are those who are trying desperately to hold on to the evil of past ways, specifically the notion that we're somehow different from each other. It's easy to see how that idea perpetuates itself with different bone structures, skin colors, or facial appearance. But underneath, as we said yesterday, we are all siblings. We are offspring of Adam and Eve, or Lucy for you diehard evolutionists. Our DNA may be distinct, alerts us to our individuality, but it is also the link that charts our connectedness all the way back to our Creator. Cutting to the chase, the event in Minneapolis that took George Floyd's life and put Derek Chauvin behind bars was another stain on the DNA of all of us. And God is watching. We should remember that when God sent Moses to set his people free, it was in response to 400 years of oppression. It turned Egypt's apple cart on its ear. The warning for America is that even though we've made great progress outlawing slavery in the 19th century, standing for freedom around the world, fiercely protecting human rights, we have moved quantum leap-wise in the last decade, moving forward to electing an African-American president twice. However, the seed of oppression still raises sprouts in the culture of 2020. We have not quite divested ourselves of oppression in the dark places of the spirit, the place where only God can see, but it's the place where it counts the most. Every soul, no matter its outward appearance or actions, is created in the image of God, Derek Chauvin and George Floyd included. And on the other hand, there is still a frightening bit of Pharisee in us all. Progress, yes. Victory, not quite. Let's pray together. Father, save us from our fear of each other. As we trust in you, surrender to your will, and listen for the soft sound of sandaled feet, help us to heed what you say to us deep down and take off our soiled inner garments. Let us be cleansed of madness. For you today, it does little to keep this to yourself. It's time to enter the discussion about what we can do, and even past time to do it. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.